as we can before we roll into our heat race action. Still got time to go down and get something at the concession stand, get yourself something hot to eat, cold to drink. I just polished me off a Western Kentucky Speedway cheeseburger. Brandon McDowell third, Clayton Miller fourth, and it goes back to Tyler Nicely, Bradley McGee, Johnny Stokes, Luke Rutter, Jared Hayes, Zach Harris rounds out the top 10. And Matt, looks like we got some factory stocks rolling out for their hot lap qualifying.
Indeed we do, Barry. Led out by the 76 machine, that's going to be Josh Phelps out of Beachmont, Kentucky. Also on the track in the 8 machine, he's seen victory lane a number of times this year. That's going to be the Bobby Gregory machine in the R59. J03 machine out of Dawson Springs, Kentucky is going to be Jake Back. Field going to be looking for green out of turn number 4. And here we are underway in hot lap qualifying in the factory stocks. Fastest in that group in the 8 machine, to the surprise of, well, probably nobody, is Bobby Gregory with a 19.8 flat. And second is the 76 of Josh Phelps with a 20.713. The 15 of Erica Ray with a 21.792. The R58 of Ricky Messamore with a 23.273. And rounding out the field in fifth is the J03 of Jake Back with a 26.623. Rolling onto the track next in the 43 machine, that's going to be Ronnie Skaggs, followed by the 28 machine of Paul Sponsel. In the 40, that's going to be Brian Crittenden, and he'll be followed in 87 by, looks like, David Crittenden. Green flag out, Western Kentucky Speedway.
Hey, Matt, while we've got just a minute, I want to thank everyone joining us on Street Stop TV here tonight. Appreciate you joining us if you're watching from home. Appreciate the fine folks at Street Stock TV for putting the action on pay-per-view here tonight. Got my buddy Flipper on the camera here tonight, so big thanks to Street Stock TV for the broadcast here tonight. Also, make sure to check out the Webster County Trojan soccer team. Got baked goods on sale. I see them over here on the turn 4 side of the grandstand. They're selling 50-50 tickets as well, so get yourself some 50-50 tickets. Got a good crowd. Be a chance to take home some cash here tonight at Western Kentucky Speedway, so get you some 50-50 tickets.
Green flag back out after that brief caution for a spin over in turn 4, trying to get this hot lap qualifying completed here at Western Kentucky Speedway. Looks to be fastest overall in hot lap qualifying here in the factory stock class. Going to be the 8 machine of Bobby Gregory with a 19.800, followed by the 43 of Ronnie Skaggs coming in second with a 20.552. And Josh Phelps in the 76 will round out your top three with a 20.713. Well, Barry, we're getting ready to roll into the next set here. So far, we've had a lot of fast cars, and I think we got a great night of racing action ahead of us.
No doubt about it, Matt. Crowd's picking up here. Got a good crowd in the stands here tonight. Track seems to be getting in better shape here, a little bit heavy early on, but seems like it's getting rolled in pretty good. We're going to roll into Rusty Bolt Hot Lap Qualifying next. Rusty Bolt Hot Lap Qualifying. Street Stocks, Street Stocks, you should be making your way to staging for qualifying. Street Stocks, quick turnaround. You're up next for your qualifying efforts, please. All right, Matt, next group rolling on the track. This is the Rusty Bolt division. They're being led out by Max Junker. Max Junker in the Y9. Also got the 5 of Tyler Shinley. Tyler Shinley in the 5 car. G03 back by popular demand, or G01. That's Blake Griffin. Blake Griffin in the G01. 197, Alan Stallings. Big Al. Alan Stallings in the 197. 12, Tommy Wilson. Tommy Wilson in the 12.
Yeah, Barry, up in turn number one, 5 machine and Tyler Shinley smacked the outside wall pretty hard. That car is leaning awful hard to the right side. Looks like he might have a flat right front, and that right front tire is broken. Barry, he pulls in the infield out of this hot lap qualifying. Significant damage to the 5 machine. Well, race fans, fastest in that flight right there, the W12 of Tommy Wilson with a 21.024. Clock it in second fastest is the G01 of Blake Griffin with a 21.369, the Y9 of Max Junker with a 21.435, and the 197 of Alan Stallings with 21.878. Rolling onto the track now, going to be led out by the 66 of Joey Summers. Joey Summers in the 66, the G03 machine. Well, Barry, you were right. Back by popular demand, it is, in fact, the flat tire himself. Derek Griffin going to take the green off turn number 4. He'll be followed by the 7 machine of Jeremy Skimhorn, and looks like the 74 of James Embry. Well, race fans, new car at the top of the charts. It's going to be the 66 of Joey Summers with a 20.610. New car in second place as well as the G03 of Derek Griffin with a 20.881. That's going to move the W12 of Tommy Wilson down to third with a 21.024.
All right, next group being led out, that is Tyler Shinley. Tyler Shinley here in the 5. I believe the other 5 was Jason Phelps, I believe, was the other 5 out there. 12 is Doyle Ware. Doyle Ware in the 12. Also on the track, 36 of Justin Ware. Justin Ware in the 36 car.
All right, race fans. Looks like no significant change in your top three up there, race fans. Everything pretty much the same. Tyler Shinley, 10th fastest in the 5 at 21.914. Justin Ware in the 36, 11th fastest at the 22.856.
Matt, the 18 here coming on the track, Donnie Cartwright, was a little bit late to staging. We're going to give him one lap on the clock. So one lap to qualify for the 18 machine of Donnie Cartwright. Street stocks, street stocks, you should be on your way to staging for your qualifying efforts. Street stocks should be on your way to staging for qualifying.
Well, that will conclude qualifying for the Rusty Bolt Division. Joey Summers, your fastest overall. Derek Griffin in second. Tommy Wilson in third. Doyle Ware in fourth. And Blake Griffin will round out your top five. So, Barry, it's looking like it's going to be a pretty good night of racing action here in the Rusty Bolt Division here at Western Kentucky Speedway. Pretty solid car count for these guys, and certainly with the track conditions that we haven't seen a whole lot. The track's been a little bit more dry slick than anything. It's certainly not been super heavy like we've got here tonight, so it's going to throw a curveball at a lot of these guys, and I'm curious to see how they're going to adjust to it.
Well, this race, this class should be wide open tonight. I saw James Dockery here in the grandstand earlier, but I guess the 28 machine not here tonight. James was victorious over at Windy Hollow Speedway last Sunday night in a 1,000 to win Rusty Bolt special over there last Sunday. But 28 has been good in this class this year. So open it up for somebody else to take home the cash here tonight in the Rusty Bolt division.
Well, race fans, Tony Wolf in the 420, fastest in that group right there, the 22.790, followed by the 26 of Keegan Hartman with a 22.918, 420B of Braden Babb with a 22.932, Tyler Logs in the 11-2 in the 11T with a 24.133, Arthur Rushlow in the 7VT with a 24.372, and Keaton Bryant rounds out the field in a 30.934. Rolling onto the track now in the 95, that's going to be Joshua Sivels. He'll be followed by the 2 machine, that is Ty Ralph. And looks like we've got the 15 machine. That's going to be Michael Birchfield. And the 18 machine, that's going to be Brandon Rickard. And looks to be the 77 machine. 77 machine going to be piloted by Trevor Smith. Trevor Smith in the 77. T2 at Trey Duncan, 20.971, first quick still. The 18R Brandon Ricker goes to second quick with a 21.254. Not quite sure here. Looks like we got Jimmy Husk in the 5 machine. He's going to go third quick with a 22.027. Trevor Smith in the 77 machine going to be 22.763. That's good enough for fourth quick. Next group rolling onto the track will be the 4 of Kevin Ashby. Kevin Ashby going to be out there along with the 23 machine. machine of Jared Ball on the racing surface out there with us. 74 machine of going to be Charlie Ashby. Charlie Ashby in the 74 junior. Keaton Bryant in the 23 machine. Kevin Ashby goes third quick in that round right there with a 21.548. 21.548 for Kevin Ashby. Charlie Ashby goes seventh quick in the 74 junior with a 22.296. 22.296 for the 74 of Charlie Ashby. On the track now in the 14, that's going to be Jared Ball. Jared Ball in the 15. Excuse me, the 14. And last qualifier of the night is going to be, looks to be the 911 of Caleb Casey. Caleb Casey in the 911. Caleb Casey getting a little topside view of the spectators up there in turn number 3. We reached the top of the berm there before returning on all fours back onto the racing surface. Caleb Casey goes to the top of the charts in the 911 with a 20.911. Tell you what, Caleb Casey takes that 911 seriously. Put it even in his lap time. Caleb Casey, top of the charts. The 14 machine of Jared Ball going to round out fifth quick at a 21.726. Second quick overall going to be the T2 of Trey Duncan with a 20.971. Brandon Ricker goes third quick with a 21.254. Kevin Ashby goes fourth quick with a 21.548. And like I said, Jared Ball with a 21.726 will round out your top five. Race fans, we've got economy action on the way here at Western Kentucky Speedway. Getting ready to roll on the track momentarily. rolling onto the track now for qualifying in the economy division in the 174. That's going to be Mason Ashby in the 64 machine. That's going to be David Carroll in the 33. That is going to be Madison Morris. In the P47, that's going to be Chad Sutton. In the 19 car, that's going to be Briar Whitaker. Coming to the checkered flag here, drawing a close to qualifying here in the economy division. Looks like the 174 Mason Ashby going to be your fast qualifier with a 22.390. David Carroll in the 64 machine goes second quick with a 22.584. Chad Sutton in the P47 goes third quick with a 23.065. Fourth quick goes to Morgan Vanover in a 23.208. Briar Whitaker goes fifth quick with a 23.775, and Madison Morris rounds out the field with a 25.229.